We're here today to talk about mechanical agitation, which is using an electrical or air-operated motor to drive an impeller to provide agitation to the slurry that's inside the shipping container in order to rehomogenize it. So when it's used in the distribution system, it's 100% homogeneous, and we don't see any variations in the solid concentration, which can lead to problems in polishing. This is a tool that we have that allows us to visualize the different types of flow patterns that are generated by different types of props and at different mixing speeds. Certain types of props are more suitable for different types of slurry. The three different types of props that we see in industry are the A100 or marine style impeller, the A310 or hydrofoil style impeller, and finally the folding blade impeller, which is one of the more popular types of props that we see out in the industry, but not one of the ones that we recommend, and I'll show you why soon. The A100 impeller is typically used for slurries that have some settling characteristics but don't have heavy settling. It's a low shear design, which has a maximized flow rate and provides flow in both a axial and a radial direction. So more or less you get a cone-shaped agitation pattern. This is good for moving a large amount of material and homogenizing slurry that might have stratified slightly over time. This is the type of prop that's used for most silica slurries and some alumina slurries. The A310 or hydrofoil style propeller is used for slurries that have heavy settling characteristics. This propeller provides a large, strong, forceful axial flow, which drives the slurry down to the bottom of the container, across and up the sides to resuspend the solids that might have built up on the bottom of the drum. This is considerably higher in shear than the A100 prop, but it does provide the solids mixing that the A100 is not capable of providing. The folding bladed prop is a kind of a hybrid design that uses an angled flat plate to give mostly rotational flow. We don't recommend the use of this type of prop simply because it doesn't do as good a job as the A100 or the A310 in either type of mixing that is required. Even at low speeds, it tends to generate a large vortex, which can be a real problem with some foaming slurries. And really, the only thing that it has going for it is the ease of insertion into the drum container. It just drops straight in. The prop itself is inserted into the drum. Secured to the mixer motor. And as you can see, it's placed within about 4 to 6 inches of the bottom of the slurry container. Rotation is always clockwise, and the vanes of the prop need to be pointing down. So the flow we're going to generate is going to be cone-shaped, directed at the bottom of the drum. One of the problems we've had is it's very difficult to visualize what's actually going on inside a non-clear drum. And as you can see, even with a clear drum, with an agitator running, it's hard to see what's going on inside. In order to help visualize in a more dynamic fashion, we use beads that we put into the container to visualize what's going on inside one of our drums when we're performing mechanical agitation. Despite the very mild appearance on the surface, there's quite a bit of flow going on down inside the container. We use two different size beads in order to show a differentiation between heavy particles and lighter particles. Ideally, our solution should show good motion of both of those in order to ensure that we're getting good mixing and a homogenized product at the end. There are a couple important points that you need to take into account when you're setting up the configuration of your mechanical agitation. First off, the mixer motor should be mounted so that the shaft and the impeller are on an angle, somewhere between 5 to 7 degrees, not purely vertical. Also, since you're putting the impeller into one of the openings in the drum, it needs to be angled so it approaches the center of the container. Now, it's also important that you don't put the mixer vertical in the center of the container, because then it'll set up rotational flow and you'll start to pull a large vortex. If you look in here, you can see a small vortex forms, but it collapses on itself before it has a chance to suck air into the slurry. That's something that we really want to avoid having happen, because it can damage the slurry, it can cause foaming, and in general, it's something we want to avoid at all costs. One of the things I had mentioned was it's important to run the propeller clockwise with the open face of the tines pointed down. If you run the mixer backwards in reverse or counterclockwise, or if you have your propeller on upside down, you can see you don't get any agitation at all. These propellers are designed to push the slurry downwards in the container, not to pull it upwards. I mean, this is a perfect example of what happens if you have your propeller on upside down or if you're running it in the wrong direction. The amount of mixing that's required by a slurry is something that we research here in our applications lab. We generate a document that is provided to the customer that goes with each individual slurry that clearly defines what's required prior to use. For slurries which require mechanical agitation, we'll give a recommendation on the prop type, the size, and the duration of mixing that's required. In some cases, over a longer shelf life, more mixing will be required than if the slurry is relatively fresh. We'll also call out that information in that handling document. The A100 impeller is used for slurries that stratify but don't settle. In general, it's used to rehomogenize the abrasive concentration in the container, which might have changed over time as it's set on the shelf. If you have solids at the bottom of the container that are appreciably higher than they are at the top of the container, when the dip tube is inserted, the high solids material are drawn out of the drum faster and at the beginning, and you can start to see sawtooths in your polishing process with higher rates or higher changes in selectivity or other polishing issues that occur because of that. By homogenizing the slurry prior to use, you can avoid all those issues and ensure that every mixed batch of slurry is exactly the same as every other mixed batch of the slurry, removing one of the sources of variation in the CMP process. Okay, now we're going to put in the A310 prop. As I mentioned before, this is a hydrofoil design, which gives it very strong axial flow. What you're going to see is a column of water, in this case water, but in practice slurry, being shot directly down into the bottom of the container, pushing across it and up the sides to give you a very vigorous turnover. This particular impeller is used for slurries that not only stratify, but actually settle abrasive on the bottom of the container over time. This is fairly aggressive, and It's really our best tool to make sure that the slurries, which do have settling characteristics, are fully homogenized prior to use. As you can see, and probably hear, this propeller provides dramatically more flow at the bottom of the container to raise and redistribute the solids that might have settled there. The speed that this runs at is anywhere from 1200 to 1725 RPM. In general, they're used at max speed with 1725 or 1500 RPMs in countries where they have 50 hertz power. As you can see, the slurry is being directed directly at the bottom of the container, across and up the sides. This is the most vigorous type of agitation that we use, and it serves to resuspend abrasives that may have built up or agglomerated on the bottom of the container. This type of mixing is used almost exclusively for cerium slurries and alumina slurries. Both of these are very shear insensitive, and they do have a tendency, because of their density, to settle or stratify severely in the bottom of the container over time. One of the other properties that's nice about this is the flow is all at the bottom of the container, where you have the largest concentration of settled abrasives. It does not generate a vortex at the top of the container. We're not sucking air into the slurry or causing any problems because of that. Now, as the mixing that we're showing here is all with a full container of material. As the level of liquid in the container goes down, you have to decrease the speed of the agitation. Otherwise, you will start to pull a vortex. Once you pull that vortex, and you can see that one shot down there but didn't collapse. The thing you'll hear when you have a sucking vortex or a collapsing vortex where air is being entrained is a gurgling noise or a rumbling noise like that. Try and avoid that whenever possible. The last type of impeller we're going to look at today is the folding bladed prop. Again, this is fairly common in industry and it's popular. However, we don't recommend using it. The reason it's the most popular is it does have the easiest insertion process of any of the propellers that we look at. However, some of the drawbacks of the flow pattern make it unsuitable for many types of slurries and ineffective at doing what it's supposed to do. At first glance, it looks like the propeller is doing a great job of mixing the abrasives on the bottom. And in fact, it is. However, the formation of this vortex is such that you're going to quickly entrain air into the slurry. And if you have a foaming slurry, you're going to generate a lot of foam, and it's going to cause a lot of problems. You can rectify this to some degree by slowing down the mixing speed. However, once the mixing speed has been slowed down, you can see that your agitation is fully rotational, and it's not doing a good job of actually moving the slurry that's at the bottom of the container upwards at all. It's just swishing it around the bottom. One of the other issues is, due to the manufacturing of the folding props, they tend not to be balanced quite as well, and you see a lot more vibration and a lot more oscillation of the mixer shaft. This can cause problems for your lifetime of your motor, and also causes additional splashing inside the container. Further slowing of the prop to the point where you don't see a vortex and you don't have the high level of oscillation shows you're really not having any effect on the abrasives at the bottom of the container. By using a folding prop, you're gaining convenience and losing the efficiency and the effectiveness that is your entire purpose behind using mechanical agitation in the first place. Now, if you really want to see a big vortex, we can speed this up a lot. Mechanical agitation is the process of choice when you have a slurry that settles heavily or actually even stratifies to a large degree. Your other options are pump recirculation or drum tumbling or drum rolling. Both of those, however, don't impart the same level of agitation and therefore don't promote the same level of homogeneity in a slurry. And just to recap, two different types of props, the A100 marine prop, the A310 hydrofoil prop. The A100 is suitable for shear sensitive slurries that require homogenization but don't have large amounts of settled abrasives. The A310 is a higher shear prop suitable for alumina or serious slurries where there can be a large amount of stratification or heavy sedimentation on the bottom of the container. Cabot Microelectronics recommends that all slurries be pre-mixed prior to use in the distribution system. Since slurries have both chemical and abrasive components, it's important that they're homogenized before they're put into the polishing process to remove any chances of irregularities or variability in the system.